And all of a sudden, all the women will have Bitcoin wallets and they will be buying things with Bitcoin. And
hello, everyone. Today, our guest is Tim Draper. Timothy Cook Draper is an American venture capital investor and founder of Draper Fisher Jurvetson, Draper University, Draper Venture Network, Draper Associates, and Draper Gorn Home. In this video, he talks about how he thinks the current government of the United States of America is too old to understand blockchain and Bitcoin. Tim Draper claims that Elon Musk will change Twitter for good and Bitcoin will rally big when his secret formula turn into reality. If you enjoy this highlight videos, please kindly subscribe and help share this video for us to share more of this valuable content. Thank you. Bitcoin briefly returned to $30,000 before the May 25 Wall Street open as range adherence lingered. Data from Cointelegraph Markets Pro and TradingView showed BTC USD managing to hit $30,189 on Bitstamp before consolidating back under the $30,000 mark. While appearing uninspiring at first glance, Bitcoin on low timeframes was a source of fresh interest for Cointelegraph contributor Michael Van de Poppe, who predicted a run to near $33,000 next. Bitcoin broke through $29,400 and ran towards the next resistance zone, he told Twitter followers. Beyond intraday price action, however, cold feet among many analysts remained. For on-chain analytics platform CryptoQuant, concerning signs from the network transaction value Golden Cross metric suggested a retracement was incoming. Designed to catch local tops and bottoms, a spike in the NBT Golden Cross, as was occurring on the day, reinforced the idea that volume was not sufficient to sustain upwards trajectory. We have a significant change in the NBT Golden Cross indicator where it has reached its most overvalued position since April last year before the dip to the June lows, CryptoQuant contributing analyst Crypto Memsimi told Cointelegraph. As Cointelegraph reported, forecasts for a generational bottom in BTC USD included as low as $15,500 this week. A new all-time high, meanwhile, might have to wait until 2024. When Bitcoin's next halving cycle begins. Tim Draper talks about the recent Bitcoin crash and predicts future prices.
These two companies, FTX and Crypto.com, have taken over the branding of two of the major US sports facilities. And neither one operates in the US.
It's unbelievable. Right. People don't realize FTX US is basically a subsidiary and some separate company. FTX itself
CFTC and the SEC argue about who's gonna regulate and who's gonna be tougher on cryptocurrencies. They are really destroying the opportunity for the US to be the leader in cryptocurrencies. That is a shame because Bitcoin creates so many interesting opportunities. I can imagine a time when I can raise a fund completely in Bitcoin. I can invest it completely in Bitcoin. I can be taxed completely in Bitcoin. I invest in my companies all in Bitcoin. The companies then pay their suppliers and customers, pay their suppliers and employees all in Bitcoin. And it's all on a smart contract and a closed loop. And if I can do that, then the whole thing can be done on the blockchain. I need no accounting, no auditing, no bookkeeping, no transfer agent. It's all done right there. That can happen in a country that allows that to happen. But the U.S. is very slow to let anything happen. And I think they're making just they're doing just the opposite of what they did with the internet. The internet, they let it rip. And they said, let's just see how it goes. But in the case of a lot of crypto, they've come slamming down on some of these crypto entrepreneurs before they even got going. And that really hurts, not having that ability to build something first in your own country really hurts, because then you start seeing these entrepreneurs moving out, and then we don't have the trust and freedom that we had for the last 200 years. Anything Elon touches what he does beautifully, turns to gold. And the reason is he gives direction to a company, and that direction is usually very visionary, and then attracts the best people in the world to go do it. And then he sets them free. He trusts them and he sets them free. And so he did that with SpaceX. He said, hey, we're going to Mars. He attracted all the best entrepreneurs, all the best engineers in the world, because they're going, hey, how are we going to get to Mars? You know, and they're all thinking about it. Then they all join him. And then he says, okay, this is what we want. A rocket to take people to Mars and back. And so let's get going on it. And every once in a while, he'll say, okay, well, first we're going to land on the space station, or first we're going to have a rocket that just lands back where it started. And then we're going to have one land on the space station. And then we're going to, you know, little by little, he's going to get us all there. But it's trust and freedom again. And so the people who work at Twitter are going to be trusted and set free to do great things. And he will make that company an amazing, amazing success. Well, what I've noticed is generally technologies are first uptaken by consumers, and then they move to the enterprise. So I think you'll start seeing NFTs go from consumer to enterprise, where now your diploma and your driver's license and your employment history and your medical records and all that stuff will go onto an NFT, and that'll be sort of a new direction for NFTs. DeFi will go from the consumer speculating, moving up and down, to the institution moving money around. And so there'll be more of that. I think, play to earn. That's definitely the consumer. The consumer is going play to earn. Well, eventually you might start seeing DAOs that are created that, now this is something that our government is just never gonna get around to understanding, but a DAO can solve all of these social problems. Is that the women will start using Bitcoin, and that it was 1 in 14 Bitcoin holders that was a woman, and now it's something like 1 in 6, and I think it'll eventually be even. And the way it's going to be even is women control about 80% of retail spend. And retailers haven't yet realized that they can save 2%, and they usually run on very thin margins, so that might like double their profits. They can save 2% just by accepting Bitcoin instead of taking a bank-issued credit card.
Right, credit card.
And that can change everything. And all of a sudden, all the women will have Bitcoin wallets, and they will be buying things with Bitcoin. And you're going to see a Bitcoin price that'll just blow right through my $250,000 estimate.
Right. I think it's going much, much higher down the road. You talk about 5 or 10 years, we're not talking about $250,000 anymore.
No.
Tim Draper clearly is not optimistic on the current American system, and particularly their politicians. He thinks they are too old to comprehend the technicalities of Bitcoin and blockchain. He claims that not only Bitcoin, but smart contracts and NFTs will change the face of the world. Let's see what lies ahead for all of us. If you enjoy this highlight videos, please kindly subscribe and help share this video for us to share more of this valuable content. Thank you.